one day we're gonna revisit the MacBook Pro 16 inch again, tear it down, and then we're gonna do a tear down.
Alright, so guys.
So, welcome back guys.
Welcome back to the Rebeltech channel.
Channel, yeah.
So, okay, today is very special because we have the MacBook Pro
16-inch
M1 Max. I have to see the specs because the specs are all foreign to me, so I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's quite new to us. So, we are still doing understanding the parts, settings, everything.
So, this is $7,000.
Huh?
This used to be $3,000, but now it's probably like $200.
So bro, you are much better on this model.
Okay.
So,
as you can see right here.
How much does it cost again?
$7.
Is it worth to buy?
$7.
$7?
$7,028.
$28.
Yeah.
Is it worth? Still worth to buy today? Is it worth buying?
Of course it's worth because it's still new. So basically this has a Japanese keyboard. It's fully customized, 64 gig.
What's the difference? RAM. Japanese keyboard and the local keyboard?
It's just the keyboard layout. So this is quite a beast. This is John Wick. This is John Wick's dog. Basically, okay, again, this is the Apple M1 Max with 10-core CPU, 32-core GPU, 16-core neural engine, and 64GB unified memory, 2TB SSD storage. But this used to be one of the best back then, and now this model is, to me, even though I'm not a fan of the new generation,
something unique about this thing, yeah. The touchpad is like big.
I can say,
yeah.
This is quite. The design is quite nice. Apple decides to put back the ports, so it's a first step, like, it's a good move.
Yeah.
So you have the SD card. You have the HDMI.
HDMI. I think it's a mini HDMI or standard HDMI.
Standard HDMI.
HDMI, and we got a lightning port. That's great. And three lightning port we have.
It's using the MagSafe.
MagSafe charger?
MagSafe 3.
Oh. What's the difference? MagSafe 3, 2, 1?
Basically, you can. It's for the new generation. You can use this MagSafe for the older Mac. So mine is MagSafe 1.
So this is 16 inch. Am I right, bro?
Yeah, let me see.
So
it's using a 140 watt USB-C power adapter.
Okay.
This is 85 watt.
Because this is quite new to us, so we haven't.
This just dropped from the sky just now, so we're actually still deciding if we should smash this MacBook.
What the?
With this, I have no idea. Smash on this, who knows?
Yeah, don't worry. He might give away this one, maybe. Subscribe more.
You should check our previous video, the giveaway on our channel. We're giving away a MacBook Pro, Steve Wozniak signed book, Lisa Jobs signed book. So there will be more giveaways.
So bro, you want to tell them
where? My iPhone 12 Pro Max also planning to give away.
Maybe.
We did this very small setup. So I'm very curious on the speaker. So
let's test the speaker.
I want to test the speaker. So here.
Yo.
Okay, this is our channel. Please subscribe to our channel.
Our another review. To my point of view, this is a bit louder, but almost the same. Not, you cannot hear much different.
mention you where, it's not really important. We'll be just chatting around about
Not bad. Speakers are about the same. The quality of the speaker is about the same. So guys, the new generation, you can't do any modification on the Mac.
Unless you build to order, like you need to...
You need to customize it during purchase it, right?
Before you purchase.
Yeah. So how about the old one, we can do it on the spot, right?
Anytime. You want to upgrade to 5 TB on your own.
You're going to give me free, right, this one? Yeah.
Then your iPhone 12, you should give away, bro.
As I said.
An iPad Pro.
As I said, if they hit 1 million, bro.
Why you need 1 million to give away your iPhone 12? You can go 6,000 subscribers.
You can do it!
That's the beloved of iPhone. You never understand.
No, we're going to give away. So, the new MacBook Pro, again, it costs $7,028.
Is this a Mac spec upgraded?
It's fully Max.
Fully Max,
Everything is all fully Max.
Okay.
So, yeah, We're not going to go in detail of the specs because I think millions of YouTubers has already done that. Basically, would I buy this MacBook Pro? More or less, yes and no. Because, it's very impressive when Apple revealed about the 14-inch and 16-inch, I was like, I think this is one of the first step to getting the classic MacBook users, Apple users to get the new MacBook. Because I'm not a fan of the touch bar, I'm not a fan of the previous generation. So even the new M1 when they first launched wasn't to my liking. But this one, I would most probably buy. But of course, it depends on your wallet and what you use it for.
Ka-ching!
If you're gonna use it for YouTube, watching movie, then you're wasting money lah. If you're gonna do content creation, video editing, and all that stuff, music production, this is the MacBook for you.
Bro, is it worth buying this to play games on it?
If you want to play games, just get a Windows laptop. Don't waste your time. Really, this is meant for, it's good for content creation.
Content.
Music production.
Video editing.
Yes, all that. It looks gorgeous. The keyboard is...
Does the keyboard come with backlight?
Yeah. It's very... Oh, this is...
This is not...
Still not sure.
Not sure the backlight.
The Japanese layout.
Yeah, it have a backlight, yeah.
So, yeah. It come very impressed with the sound.
We do again.
This is our channel. Again,
hello you lovely people of the tube. Welcome to the Rebeltech channel.
Really?
Okay, so we're in
impressive.
Another location. Again, we're not
gonna. This one have a 4 stereo speaker, or maybe 2. No idea, because we have not teared down any of the internal parts yet. Might be in future.
Staying safe, staying
healthy. Yeah, we're gonna do a tear down in future. Not now, definitely. Tonight is basically showing you the gorgeous display of the MacBook Pro. This is cool.
Wow, engraved.
You can see, this is really cool.
Yep.
This reminds me of back then when you engrave on iPods. So you have, hold on, let me see, it's the same setup of screws set for the center. Right, yeah, this is nice. This is very nice. Okay, what's inside the box is basically...
You have the charger.
You have the charger here.
Type C, 140 watts, right?
140 adapter. Watts,
yeah.
Type C.
MagSafe
3.
MagSafe 3.
Very straightforward.
Bucket and that's it.
Okay, let's see what's inside. We actually will...
Yeah, can the MacBook be charged by a Type C charger?
Not sure about that. Is it, Ken? Yeah.
Okay.
The Apple guy say yes. He's behind the screen. What's your name again, bro?
Anonymous.
He's shy.
Bruh.
Okay, so you have the sticker decal, which is cool. And yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Anything hidden inside below the box?
No cloth. So what's this? Let me see. blah.
The manual, right? This is the instruction manual.
Actually, all these are a waste of paper. But why Apple? Why you?
Don't be stingy, Apple. Please provide the cloth, fiber cloth.
Sell the cloth individually, but it's all right. Okay, this is what's inside the box. Nothing much, but don't throw away the box. It's, I know some people will love once they unbox, they will discard this box.
Yep.
I'm like, this is worth keeping. Okay, back to this. Because I'm still quite impressed with the...
Yeah, they still keep the microphone jack. So that's a good good thing. Yeah, they still have it.
As you can see, Type-C, two Type-C, one headphone jack, one MagSafe, three ports.
Yep.
Can you see? HDMI.
Don't worry, I hold it below. So I will catch it.
I have no angle, okay. HDMI, Type-C, SD card reader, which is good.
Yeah, one thing, they have a Touch ID on the off-on button. Yeah,
this is
on.
How you power on. See, this is the keyboard, Japanese keyboard layout is customized. Where we are here is not in Japan, but basically it looks cool.
Cool.
Okay, so if you were to purchase this MacBook, please don't be stingy. Go get yourself Apple Care Plus.
Yep. You never know when you need it. If you keep it handy.
And also, if you buy this, please go all out. Basically, the max specs. I'm like, why you get the, you know, 8GB or whatever low end spec? You should be going all out for the all the new generation models, because there will be a time that you go, there's not enough space, and then you go send this to shop and ask them to upgrade. I'm like, bro, I'm like, you can't upgrade this. So you, before you purchase, you decide first on what to get. Most safest is 500 gig to 1 terabyte. This is 2 terabyte, because we use a lot of data here, and you don't get 256 gig. 500 gig to 1 terabyte is more than enough. Overkill is 2 terabyte, which is much more safer. But of course, for all these drives, you know, you backup every day, because anything can happen. You probably spill liquid on it, accidental spill and all that stuff. So all this can happen, might happen. And
do protect your MacBook. Yeah,
this is what you should be, you know, they should do on the previous Mac, because this is, you know, if you accidentally pull or, you know, trip on it, you know, this can just disconnect.
I thought all Mac is like that, bro.
The previous generation is Type-C, so when you accidentally pull the cable, the whole MacBook will, you know, it will drop.
It will drop, yeah.
So I'm not sure why the design team previously...
No, it previously was Type-C, right? They bring back the old
they should. Magnetic. The MagSafe.
Yeah, MagSafe.
It's perfect on its own. It's like, so you can see side by side. It's stupid to compare these two models together, lah. It's...
The weight of this is much different.
This is quite heavy.
Yeah, this is much lighter. So
it's not really light. Still some people will
still say slim, lah.
It's heavy. F*** you, bro. You want light stuff? You just carry your phone.
Show them anything? Nothing else much.
That's about it. Because I think very impressed with this. This is basically also an unusual tech review, because we're doing this outside. But yeah, one day we're gonna revisit the MacBook Pro 16-inch again.
Tear down.
And then we're gonna do a tear down. Oh, yeah.
Don't forget, yeah? He's gonna give it away, his MacBook Pro.
Hopefully.
YouTubers doing who that. Are doing it.
So now we're not gonna tear down. This is still new. It's like still fresh from the oven. And yeah, again, Apple Care Plus, make sure. Don't be stingy on the specs. Make sure you go all out. Don't regret later on, and don't go to Apple Store and say, can you please upgrade my MacBook to 16 gig? Most of the RAMs are all soldered on. So basically, you can't upgrade RAM. It depends on models, it depends on brands. Storage wise, it depends also. Mac, no.
How about the memory? The SSD is...
It's all soldered on.
You cannot upgrade or additional SSD to put.
No. Wow. It's only all custom built to order. When you
too bad.
Go to Apple Store, you click. Make sure you don't go, this $50, it's $100, you know, $200 very expensive to you know. You do it on your own. Do it directly on the Apple Store website.
Before you click the icon, check out.
Don't buy the 8GB and then you send to a shop which can do, upgrading, unsolder, desolder. I'm like, bro, what's the logic? You just want to save 50 cents and then you risk breaking your $3,000 Mac.
Bro. So we have nothing else. Yeah. And we'd like to say thank you again to the anonymous person. Yeah. And that's all. Signing out from our channel, Rebeltech. Peace.
Let's go. Thank you. Arigato. Okay. Let's go. Done.